I'm Sonia from Sonia Says Sit. Here's another behaviour that you'll learn in our puppy preschool, group classes, or one-on-one in-home lessons. For more details or to book, you can head to our website, soniasaysit.com. We hope to train with you soon. So we're going to practice our leave it now with a different item. And this is a skill that is essential. You will have lots of opportunities while you've got a little puppy to ask them to leave things alone, whether that's somebody's shoelaces or it's something that they shouldn't eat. It could be the dead fish head on the beach with a hook in it. There's so many different examples of where and how you could use leave it. And once they have this skill, it means that you don't have to stress as much in terms of how, like, has the skill of open your mouth. We still want that to be a really good skill, but if we can prevent them from putting that thing in their mouth in the first place, whether it is the shoelace, whether it is the person's sock, whatever that might be that your puppy is currently taking of yours and making chases with it, okay? When we were just talking about drop it, we didn't say that, but we'll definitely talk about that in the class. Don't have a game of chases. So let's say the puppy has taken the sock. I'll just do a little bit of really real relaxation while I explain that. Let's say the puppy has taken the sock. If you chase them, if you get the sock and you tug it and try and get it out of their mouth, what you're teaching them is that when they get the sock, you will give them a game. You will play tug of war, you will chase them, and we've accidentally reinforced that the sock is the most valuable toy in the house. So on the flip side of teaching puppies to open their mouth and leave things alone, we also need to make sure we are teaching them that the toys that they have that they enjoy, we give them attention when they have them. So where's the rope toy? Where's the ball? We can let the puppies know that they are the toys, and if you get them, I will play chase, I will play tug of war. Alright, so we're going to do leave it. So this item, I show Chili, I'll just get him to lick my fingers a little bit more because we've got lots of food on there. Good boy, thank you. Alright, so I'm going to show him the item, see this, and then say leave it and put the item on my knee. Good. If he doesn't come over to investigate, I can mark and reinforce that. Sometimes in the classes we hear people say, excuse me, that the puppy isn't or wasn't interested in the lid. That's okay, because that's the whole point. We're making it as easy as possible so they will leave the lid alone. Chili. See this? Leave it. Good. So twice I've done it on my knee. Now what we're going to do is put it down and a bit closer. I'm actually going to put it on the side of the bed so you can see it and he can see it. Because if I put it on the ground, he won't see it. So show the puppy. Leave it. Good. Okay, he interacted with it. You could see that he looked at it, but he didn't go and put it in his mouth. All right. The other skill that I said when we were playing with the peg and we were doing the open your mouth skill was I said, get it. All right, so remember, if you say to your puppy that they can have it, then that makes, you've changed the dynamics, you've changed the rules. See this? Leave it. Good. As you can see, I'm not luring him away from this item. I'm actually letting him choose to leave the item alone. If you think back and how we did our sit to say please with the food in our hand and him pulling back from that, good. It's a similar skill, okay? We're asking the dog to disengage with the item. The last level is adding in a little bit of prey drive where I will drop this item to see if that increases his interest in the item. See this? Leave it. Good. Good boy. Good boy, Chili. So as you can see, the prey drive, where this boring lid was left alone when it was on my knee and on the edge of the bed, as soon as it bounced, he gained a lot more interest. So that prey drive is something that you want to wait to work on until, good, you've already established that the dog can leave it and you don't have to cover it. If I was covering it up here and he was pouring at it and trying to get to it, I wouldn't have put it on the bed. So just work with the dog in front of you. If you need to cover it, like a little cage over it at each level, that's fine. Just work at that level until you can leave it uncovered. So now, because he's interested in it, oh, we've seen a fly. Did you see the fly? I'm actually going to reinforce him by giving him this item. Are you ready? Get it. Drop it. So he likes this one, so I'm going to have to offer the exchange. So I'm going to put a piece of food in my hand. Good. And he dropped it as soon as the piece of food was in my hand. So if your puppy needs help remembering their drop it, okay, that's where they've got the item. So let's give it back to him again. Get it. Drop it. Good. Let it fall. Don't snatch it. If he chooses to pick it back up, that's just another chance to do another repetition of open your mouth. They love chewing on little things at the moment with their teething, so don't be surprised if they want to give it a bit of a chew. And we're not worried because it's not my shoe, it's not the TV remote, it's a plastic lid. Chili. Good. So the cupped hand, as well as your verbal cue of drop it or thank you or ta, ends up meaning open your mouth. And you can trust me, I'm not going to steal it from you. If I reach in and snatch it, the dog is going to be less likely to want to open their mouth and trust me. Okay, so we've got the opposite skills of don't put that in your mouth and open your mouth. You get it. You get it. Good boy. Drop it. Good.